All right. Welcome back to Eyes Open Media. Prophet John here. Hope you guys are doing well. It's 8 in the morning, May 22nd, 2021. This is day 35 of the detox of 90 days. And, okay, so I hope you guys are doing better. Hope you guys are doing well. Hope you guys are getting healed of every sickness and disease. And hope your detox is going well. Okay, we'll continue to pray today for everybody, including myself, and as we get stronger and stronger throughout these 90 days. Okay, crypto markets are in the red today. I'm looking to maneuver, trying to strategize. I need the Lord's help, though. You know, to get some funds, to get more funds, because you know I'm trying to get a certain amount of tea fuel, and I need the Lord to make some things happen for me to get that. So, just trying to strategize and see how I'm going to be able to pull this off within the next 39 days. We got 39 days till Mainnet 3.0, and we know that when the 30 days hit, that's when people start to start the buying frenzy starts. So I really only have like 9 days to try to figure this out and how I'm going to be able to get as much tea fuel as I can before the buying frenzy really begins. Other than that, it is what it is. Okay. We're going to be looking at silver, next week, see if silver, starts to hit $30. That's going to be interesting. Test of $30 next week, most likely for silver, as we started to see gold and silver, breaking through, this week we started seeing silver breaking through with gold, but silver did fall a little bit there, at the end of the week. But, we got some short positions starting to cover their silver, stocks. So that's a sign that, silver could be ready to test that $30 next week. So we'll have to wait and see. Congressional hearing is supposed to be next week as well on silver. So they might send it up next week just for that reason. So who knows? We just have to wait and see how that plays out. You know, it could be a buy the rumor, sell the news event as well. So who knows? Theta is was added to Uphold. So that's awesome. So our Theta coin was added to Uphold Exchange. A lot of you guys use Uphold Exchange, so it was added to Uphold Exchange. And then it was also added to Exodus. So Theta and T Fuel were added to Exodus. Uphold only added Theta. They didn't add Theta Fuel yet. So interesting. So we're starting to see Theta and Theta Fuel start to get added on exchanges. What we need to see now is Coinbase, Gemini, Kraken, Bittrex, Binance USA. Once we see Theta on Binance USA, then we're gonna see it on everywhere else. Because remember, Binance holds a lot of Theta, and they hold a lot of T fuel and Theta, and they're staking it. So why wouldn't they add it to Binance USA already, right? When they're so heavy into the company, it's because Theta has not told them to do it yet. For me personally, I think Theta is waiting for the big exchanges. I think Theta is waiting for the outcome of XRP, in my opinion. I've been saying that for months and months and months now. I think Theta is waiting for the outcome of XRP, and we could see an outcome of XRP by the end of the month or early or the first week of June, in my opinion. So we're waiting on some type of settlement agreement with XRP, and I think that's when Theta is going to start adding coins. So watch the first week of June, okay? Because that coincides with basically 30 days left to Mainnet 3.0, and I think we're going to see an outcome with XRP. And I think Theta is then going to say it's going to have give these exchanges the green light to add it. And that's going to fuel the Theta, massive Theta run for Mainnet 3.0. So that may be their strategy to hold these exchanges off. Some exchanges have gone, Exodus, private wallet exchange and wallet, and then Uphold has added. I think a lot of these other exchanges are going to be adding Theta in the first week of June with 30 days left to go with the Mainnet 3.0. And that's going to fuel, that could fuel the run all the way up to Mainnet 3.0. We'll have to just wait and see. Okay. So that's what's going on. We're still waiting for the Arizona audits and the Arizona audits results. Not Arizona, yeah, Arizona, New Hampshire. Looks like Georgia's gonna try to. They filed a lawsuit for the discrepancies in the election numbers. More people voted than there actually were people, and things like that. There's just so many, and same thing in Michigan. So people are still fighting this election stuff because the fraud was so heavy, and so that's what they're doing now. And it's interesting to see, for the shot, right? The shot. We have these Hollywood actors that are being paid, to come on YouTube commercials now, and they're coming all over commercials on social media. They're saying, look, man, you need to take, you need to get the shot. Stop believing all the things that you're seeing on social media with people, having these magnets and being able to be magnetized. I seen one guy. He was able to go up to a TV, and the TV was trying to connect to him. He pulled his phone out. His phone's trying to connect to him. It's Bluetooth. It's trying to connect to him. These people that have taken the shot are turning into transhumanism. You're now you're part human, part internet. You become a internet man. You become Wi-Fi. Unbelievable. Can you imagine if they turn on CERN or turn on 5G heavily, and you can all that magnet and radioactivity is just literally burning you alive. I mean, golly, I mean, that's not pretty. That's not fun at all. I mean, the fact that people are getting stuck to magnets and metals now, and that thing is going throughout their entire bodies. Oh my goodness. You can only imagine what these people are gonna have to go through in the next 6 to 7 months, or next year, as their whole entire body become magnetic. Oh boy, Magneto. Prophet Shirley said Magneto. Everybody's turning into Magneto. Yeah, they are. That's so sad. And these actors know exactly the dangers, and they're being paid. 'Cause they think that people are so stupid that even when people realize that they've been deceived, and that they're in big trouble, and they're turning into transhumanisms and zombies and stuff, that these actors believe that nothing's gonna happen to them. So that's why they're getting paychecks to say, hey, you need to take the shot. You need to take the shot. Let's be safe and take the shot. Yeah, with a virus with a 99% survival rating. Yeah. How about we take what we see in the pictures here? How about we take some fruits and vegetables, some beets, and some eggplants and beets, and tomatoes and green peppers, and celeries and broccoli, and some kale, and some watermelon, and some cantaloupes. Pineapples. How about we some raspberries and blueberries and strawberries? How about we take some fruits and vegetables? How about we alkaline the body? A virus cannot be in an alkaline body. So how about we just alkaline our bodies? How about we take CMOS? How about we take Honduras greens? Have you noticed that they don't talk about these things as solutions? First, it was about the virus. Now it's no longer about the virus. It's all about the shot now. But they won't tell you any other solutions but the shot. They won't tell you to alkaline your body and take some CMOS and some Honduras greens and stuff, and some and eat a clean diet. Not once are they telling you that. They're saying your only solution is the shot. That they know nothing about. They don't know nothing that's in it. and yet everybody's getting stuck the metals, and it's activating your Bluetooth. Godly, terrible, terrible, terrible. But this is what they're gonna do with the microchip as well. They're gonna have the celebrities go out there and say, "Look, I've been microchipped. I'm fine." It's unbelievable. But this is the brainwashing. That's the mind control. That mind control is part of the mark of the beast. It's one of the many mark of the beast, mind control. This is how people are gonna get fooled and deceived. So hopefully, many of you guys have not taken the shot, and you will never take the shot, and you'll never take the microchip, and you'll never take any other thing that the beast system offers you. And you're gonna be loyal to God and to the Holy Spirit and Yeshua. Okay, so loyalty is the key here, right? Anyways, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you that we have a discernment, and you have given us the wisdom and discernment to make it through any of the beast activities, any of the Antichrist activities, any of the weapons of the Antichrist, any of the weapons of the beast system. You're going to give us favor. You're going to give us wisdom and courage to stand up and say, no, we're not going to take this. And no, we're not going to fall to the Antichrist system and be thrown in the lake of fire. We're not going to do that. We're not going to do that. We're going to stand tall, even if we have to stand before millions of people. And we're going to reject, like David did. We're going to reject Prophet David did. We're going to reject the beast system and the products of the beast system. We're going to be wise, and we're going to be smart. In Yeshua's mighty name, thank you for the wisdom. Thank you for the knowledge. Thank you for showing us that this is not of you. Then thank you for quickly showing and telling your prophets, 6 7 months in advance, that this thing that was coming was not of you, and that we should avoid it at all costs. We thank you, Father, for giving us this the knowledge and the wisdom and the visions to be able to help people to make the right decisions and stay in the godly kingdom. We thank you, Father, and all those people that did take it, Father, that's between you and them, in Yeshua's name. We can't really do anything, because there isn't a reversal shot. If there was a reversal shot, it'd be a different story. If you want us to create a reversal shot, Father, show us how to do it, and we can help people. We don't want to see people go to the lake of fire. We don't want to see people torture to death. We don't want to see people turn into transhumanism and zombies and lose their mental capacity and have early and have the severe dementia and all these things that are going to come with the shot. We don't want to see people go through this, Father. We don't want to see the infiltrate, what's it called? Not being able to have have babies and stuff, infertility, right? Something like that. You guys know what I'm talking about. But yeah, we don't want to see that either. We want people to be healthy, lo loving, peaceful, and kind, and live a great long life. But they need to. But we also need to have wisdom. And the wisdom of the Holy Spirit. And when we make these big decisions, we must put God first. God has to be in these decisions with us. And a lot of people made these decisions off of what the media said and not what God said. And so people made the decision not asking God, but they went and got their shot because the media scared them into getting their shots. That's called mind control. You must go to God first for everything, especially these types of decisions. And Father, we go to you now, and we ask you, Father, to keep us strong in this beast system. Keep us strong in this Antichrist system. Keep us strong and keep us going in Yeshua's mighty name. Father, we repent for every sin that we have committed and done. Wash us clean from the top of our heads to the bottom of our feet. Remove every sin that we have committed and done, and we repent for everything. We repent for treating people wrong. We repent for our thoughts. We repent for everything in our heart. We repent for everything that we see that is negative and evil. We repent for everything that we hear that is negative and evil. Wash us clean completely, and change our mindsets and change our lives. We cancel every demonic dream, vision, entity, witches, warlock, sorcerers, astral projection, landline, land cores, and demons. We cancel all those things now. We cancel it. We cancel. We cancel every dream that is evil, negative, demonic. And we cancel all dreams that other people had of us as well. And we send it to the feet of Yeshua for judgment and destruction. And we cover with the blood of Yeshua and the power of the Ruach HaKadosh, Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, every single piece of money that we have given, every time, all our time that we have given, everything that we have given to others, may we be blessed back a billionfold now. And Heavenly Father, we cover our finances today. We, from the south, north, south, east, and west, we cover our finances today. We bless our finances. We bless ourselves. And we cover ourselves from any harm in Yeshua's name. And we rebuke and remove every vagabond spirits, and we command positive spirits, favored spirits, blessing spirits, wealthy spirits, wealth transfers in our lives. In Yeshua's mighty name, let next week be a wealth transfer week. In Yeshua's mighty name, we pray. Shalom, shalom, shalom. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Touch our head to the bottom of our feet. And we thank you for healing us of every sickness and disease. Thank you for powering up our immune systems in this time period. And let our immune systems be stronger than ever in Yeshua's mighty name. We burn out all the allergies. We burn out all the sickness and disease. We burn out all the STDs. We burn out all the AIDS and cancer and diabetes and gluttony and tumors. We burn all those things out through the Holy Spirit. We burn out every stomach problems. We burn out everything in Yeshua's mighty name. We burn everything out of us, Father. We can hear, we can see, we can smell, we can taste, we burn out the arthritis. We burn out the joint problems, the back problems. We burn everything out of us now through the Holy Spirit in Yeshua's name. We cover ourselves with the blood of Yeshua, and we ask the Holy Spirit to fill us up in Yeshua's mighty name. We pray. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Father, your gold and silver, it's time to shine. It's time to shine. It's time to shine. Your gold and silver, it's time to shine. In Yeshua's mighty name, we pray. Shalom, shalom. All right, guys and girls, hope you guys enjoyed that. Be safe. Be smart. Don't give in to world pressures. Trust God. Lean on God. And lean on your spiritual family. You'll be okay. All right. So that's what we do. We don't trust the world. We don't trust anything the world says. We only trust God and what the God says, the Holy Spirit and Yeshua says, and we trust them, and we get confirmations through the prophets. In Yeshua's name, we pray. Shalom. Eyes open.